In this lesson, we will play with the menu of your app. The menu, also called the browsing mode, is a great way to create a secondary navigation inside your app. Here, you have several examples of browsing modes used on the same app. To work on the browsing mode of your app, go to the Builder menu and select Browsing Modes. This section of the Builder is divided in three parts: Menu, Settings, and Templates. 7 templates can be used to build your navigation mode. Let's choose the swipe and see how to customize it. 4 types of elements can be used in your browsing mode. Links and shortcuts are pointers to a destination. This destination can be inside the app or outside. And title breaks and separators are design elements that you are going to use to organize the information inside your browsing mode. You arrange your elements inside the zones of your browsing mode. In this example, I have 3 zones. Let's add a new element inside the body of my swipe navigation. I want it to be a destination, so I choose link. Now I need to set the title of my link and the destination. It can be a section of my app, it can be an action, or an external link. Let's choose the contact us section of this app. As you can see, the menu is independent from the structure of your content inside the app, from the number of sections you have. And this is a very powerful feature because you can build the secondary navigation you want, whatever the organization. Okay, now let's have some fun. I have prepared some examples and let's see how you can make what you see here on the screen. With those 3 first examples, we are going to work mainly on the body of the navigation mode, and let's start to add the icons next to the titles of the links. When you edit a link, you will see this feature this link option. If you turn it on, it will be possible then to display the icon of the link. By repeating the process, I have added icons next to all my links. To fit with my examples, I need to align my links on the left. This is done by going to the Settings tab, and in the body, you can choose the horizontal alignment. Let's choose left. I'm pretty close to the example in the middle. What needs to be changed is the color of the selected item and non-selected item. Let's see how we can put Petit Chef on top and the copyright Petit Chef at the bottom, for instance. In the Settings header, I can choose the vertical position of my header. So now Petit Chef is on top. I can align it on the left. I go back to the menu and I add a new element in the footer, a copyright element. Petit Chef is added. Then back to Settings, Footer, I can choose to position it at the bottom of the swipe. Look how this link stands out from the others. Let's do it in our menu. Start by editing the link from the Menu tab. The link is already featured. I'm going to change the not selected color and the background color. The link is now much more visible in my navigation. Let's play now with the header and try to reproduce what we can see here. Let's add a new element in the header and I choose the account. Let's move it above the title. Now I go to the settings, I detach the header from the top, and I center it. We have reproduced this header. Let's do this one now. I start by removing the title. If I want to put it back, I add the logo type element. Now let's add shortcuts. My first shortcut is added, I click on it, I choose an icon, and the destination. Depending on my destination, I can even choose a specific page. Let's add a second shortcut using the plus. For the destination, I choose my profile and the push history, and I add my third shortcut. The destination for this one will be an action, calling the number of my restaurant. The final touch to match my example is to add a new element, a separator. The color is black in my example. And put back the header on top of the navigation. We're pretty close to match the example now. Now it's time for you to practice. Here are three new examples. You know how to work on the header, on the footer, to reproduce them. In this last example, there is a new element, the title break, that we didn't cover in this video, but it's very simple to use. I let you discover how it works. So we spent the video to work on the swipe navigation, but it's the same concept for the other navigation modes. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy upbuilding!